And the Philippines will temporarily close its airspace on May 17th to make way for an airport maintenance operation. This report from Vivian Gulia.
The task force ordered by Transportation Secretary Jaime Bautista to probe Monday's power outages at the Ninoy Aquino International Airport Terminal 3 held its first meeting on Tuesday. These include representatives from the DOTR, Manila International Airport Authority, Office of the Transportation Security, National Intelligence Coordinating Agency, and Meralco.
We're not saying it's sabotage. We're also not saying it's not sabotage. We're not discounting any possible items. Kasi yung iba nagsasabi, how come it's always on a holiday? We don't want to rule out anything as of this time.
Operations at NAIA 3 have since normalized after it experienced two power outages on Monday.
We were able to actually already recover most of the flights. So today, as mentioned, there are only around 4 round-trip domestic flights that are delayed from Cebu Pacific. But the rest of their schedule is on time. We don't expect any spillover by tomorrow.
Initial investigations showed that a fault current on AIA 3's load side caused the 1 a.m. power outage on Monday. MIA meanwhile attributes the brief power interruption on Monday afternoon to a power fluctuation.
Nagkaroon ng fluctuation possibly because as an effect also of what happened in the morning. That was around 3:59 or 4 o'clock na fully restored siya by 4:23. The afternoon fluctuation did not cause any cancellations of flights.
Annalyn was emotional as she narrated her experience after her flight back to Pagadian was canceled due to the more than 7-hour power outage. She spent the night at the airport terminal waiting for her new flight schedule.
Hindi na ako lumabas ng airport kasi magastos, walang pambayad ng hotel. Para ako na trauma actually kasi ganito pala yung Manila. Mahirap mabuhay dito talaga.
Meantime, the Philippine airspace will be shut down for 6 hours on May 17th from 12 midnight to 6 a.m. to give way to the replacement of the uninterruptible power supply or the UPS at the country's Air Traffic Management Center. That announcement coming from MIA, saying it is an offshoot of the technical glitch that paralyzed NAIA's operations last January 1st.
What will happen there is for 6 hours, wala talaga activity sa ating airspace. So let's say a flight that's supposed to arrive in Davao by 12 o'clock, the last flights out of Manila would be at around 10:30.
Yung pong pagpapalit ko ng ating uninterruptible power supply requires a total shutdown of the power supply. Iyan po kasi yung UPS, umiidad na po siya. Ang trabaho po niyan is to regulate for yung pong quality ng ating kuryente para po maiwasan yung mga fluctuations.
Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News.
Some international flights at the Ninoy Aquino International Airport were delayed due to the maintenance activity. Our correspondent Andrea Taguines now joins us for more details. Andrea, go ahead. Good morning.
Good morning, Nikki. Flights have resumed here at the Ninoy Aquino International Airport following some maintenance work done on the automatic voltage regulator, or AVR, of the Philippine Air Traffic Management Center early this morning. The country's airspace was shut down from 2 a.m. to 4 a.m. to give way to those repairs, but it actually ended earlier than expected at 3:27 a.m., according to the Civil Aviation Authority of the Philippines. Still, there were more than 24 flights that were delayed. We were able to talk to one of the affected passengers over at NAIA Terminal 1, an overseas Filipino worker who is returning to Singapore today. His flight was originally scheduled at 5:55 a.m., but when he arrived at the airport, he found out that his flight was moved to 7 a.m. But he wasn't too upset about it because he said he was given a heads up by Philippine Airlines that this could happen because of the maintenance work. We also spoke to a foreigner flying out to Taipei this morning before heading home to Los Angeles. He said he got nervous when he learned about the maintenance work, but thankfully his flight proceeded as scheduled.
Ang pagkakala ko, pagka first flight, hindi pwedeng madali dahil nandiyan ang aeroplano. Pero kung ang problema sa airport, yun ang talagang madali. Oh, okay lang. Kasi alam ko may problema ang Maya eh. Hindi natin maiwasan yan. Pero kung mga isang araw, hindi naman okay yun.
Well, I got a long day of flights ahead of me, so it would bum me out. It would just make my day that much longer. I got 14 hours of flight, of air time, so any delay will just really bum me out. It'll hurt my back even more.
Nikki, we also tried to check if there were still some stranded passengers at Naia Terminal 3 due to the power outage that occurred on Monday, Labor Day, but so far we haven't encountered any yet. Although there are a lot of travelers waiting around, when we spoke to them, some of them told me that their flights today are on schedule and that they just came early so that they will not be late. Nikki?
All right. Thanks for that update, Andrea.
The Philippine Ombudsman orders the preventive suspension of the head of Manila's airport authority. Cesar Chong said he received Tuesday the April 28 order for alleged grave abuse of authority. Chong said the Ombudsman's order was based on an anonymous complaint after he reassigned several employees at the agency. But he insisted the move was meant to improve airport operations. Chong is also confident he will be cleared of the allegations. The Ombudsman has yet to issue a copy of the order.
An agricultural group alarmed as the entry of smuggled agricultural products continue to flood Philippine ports. Sherian Torres now saw some senators eye creating a dedicated port to handle smuggling cases.
Philippine senators want tougher laws to combat agricultural smuggling. Lawmakers are suggesting various ways to discourage the illegal entry of goods, including a dedicated court to handle smuggling cases and making government officials equally liable for failing to prosecute these illicit activities. For Senator Cynthia Villar, the possibility of imprisonment, even during trial, is a strong disincentive.
Maybe we can add, Mr. Chairman, a specific crime, refusal to prosecute large-scale agricultural smuggling.
Or so, who is parang, will be liable, Your Honor?
The legal departments, even the DOJ prosecutors, Mr. Chairman, depending on the evidence. These are possible evidence we can use in this new crime. Parang obstruction of justice ito, but very specific.
Madidemanda dito, mayayaman. The only magagawa mo sa kanila para mapatigil sila is makulong sila. Kasi yung mayayaman ayaw makulong. During the time of the period of cases, nakakulong sila. That's enough punishment for them because they are rich people.
Court Administrator Raul Villanueva and officers of the Philippine Judges Association agree with the lawmakers. They believe adding these provisions would further strengthen the anti-smuggling law. Agriculture group Samahang Industriya ng Agrikultura or SINAG says agricultural smuggling is a big business. Goods entering the country are worth millions of pesos. Stakeholders, however, point out no one has been successfully prosecuted.
Ang smuggling matagal na. Talagang off and on, pag mainit, tatahimik yan. Ang pinakamagandang na pwede maghabla ay ang competitor mismo. Sapagkat yung competitor ang masigasig na lalabanan yan hanggang sa kaduluduluhan. We are losing, the last time we made a study, 250 billion pesos in value-added tax and downsizing of companies.
Tumatagal ang kaso. Only the BOC can file, tapos ang daming dinadaan ng process. Yung last hearing po sa Senate din, parang 300 plus yung pending na kaso. At ang glaring, walang conviction.
According to a customs official, they've filed 24 cases to the DOJ in 2022 and nearly twice the number of cases this year.
All the cases are still for preliminary under investigation with the Department of Justice.
Preventing smuggled goods from entering the market is also a huge problem. The Bureau of Customs says it is doing everything they can.
Lahat po ng smuggling na hinuhuli ngayon sa mga warehouses. Ang tanong ko ho, paano nakalabas sa custom?
We have tried our best to file cases against, to strengthen border protection. Anyway, paano siya nakakalabas? Hindi ko na talaga alam.
Sherian Torres, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine Health Department logged over 4,000 new COVID cases last week. That is more than 1,000 higher than the previous week. But DOH Officer in Charge Maria Rosario Vergere says the recent number of new COVID cases is still considered few and that the healthcare utilization rate remains at low risk. The DOH meanwhile warns the upward trend in COVID cases may continue until June. But for now, they still see no reason to restore the mandatory use of face masks.
We already have recommended to the Office of the President, based on the agreements coming from the IATF discussions, na hindi naman kailangan ibalik ang mandato. Kailangan lang talaga ma-shift na natin ang mindset ng ating mga kababayan. Tataas, bababa ang mga kaso dito sa ating bansa dahil nandito pa rin naman po yung virus, hindi nawawala. Ang kailangan lamang po natin talaga lahat ay matuto tayo, bawat sarili natin, alam natin kung paano natin poproteksyonan ang sarili pati ang ating pamilya.
State Weather Bureau PAGASA raised an El Nino alert on Tuesday. It says forecasts now show an 80% probability of the weather phenomenon developing as early as June. But it adds, with El Nino developing close to the rainy season, the country should brace for heavy rains. PAGASA says the western section of the country will experience more torrential downpours brought about by the southwest monsoon. That includes Palawan, Panay Islands, and even Metro Manila. Local governments are urged to plan and prepare ahead for their response to heavy rains.
That would mean pwede tayo magkaroon ng mga heavy rainfall events, mga pagbabaha, and then yung mga potential for landslide, yung mga vulnerable areas, possible yon, posible yon. Although hindi naman natin, wag sana mangyari yon, but then kailangan tayong maging prepared dahil ito pong sinasabi natin is based dun sa historical account